Let's get ready for the NCAA Track and Field Championships and head to Worcester, where we visit with one of the top javelin throwers and youngest javelin throwers, not only in the NE10, but in the country, because Malina Bohlmann is headed to the NCAA Championships from Assumption. First off, congratulations on a great first season and an NCAA title, or an NE10 title.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
How did we get here?
Okay, so it's kind of a weird story. I first came to college, I wasn't playing a sport, and I knew some people on the track team, and I was like, I want to do something, I want to get involved. And so after winter break, I just emailed the coach, you know, talked to her, and she was like, we'd love to have you on the team. So I just kind of walked on, kind of tested the waters, I guess, and I just started throwing some javelin. So
how did we go from not on the team and just a regular college student at Assumption to the NE10 champion and getting a bid to the NCAA championship?
Well, I actually played basketball and volleyball a lot. And so that's what I wanted to do in college, but I did participate in track in high school. I knew I could do the events and stuff, but I just didn't know if I wanted to do that in college. Once I joined, I mean, obviously college track is a whole different ball game. So we were hitting lifts, we were doing a lot of javelin specific work. And I think that's how I kind of progressed in a fast way to get to where I am now. But
when did it click that, like, all right, I'm good at this, and it's not just something I'm going to do, but I've got a chance to really make some noise?
Probably actually at the NE10 meet when I PR'd, and like, a bunch of my teammates were coming up to me being like, you don't even know what you just did. Like, you don't understand. And I was like, I don't know. They were so supportive of me. And they told me, like, you can do anything you want from here. And, you know, just making nationals in itself is insane. And so, I don't know. I think that there's a lot I can do with it. And I just hope that everything is a positive outcome from here on out. But
how much have you PR'd? Like, what were you throwing before?
So yeah, in high school I threw like 120. I don't really know the meters, sorry, but and this, my PR now is 152, so I PR'd by about 30 feet, which is
walk me through that PR, because I was there at the NE10 championship when you threw it, and it was really cool to see your teammates respond the way that they did. What was running through your mind?
Honestly, I just wanted to stay calm, because usually I can get kind of in my head at big meets and stuff. So I just wanted to stay calm. I knew I was in first, like the seated first, so I just wanted to keep that position. And I was locked into finals in the first position. And so on that first throw, I was just like, you know, I need to throw it far. Like, I need to let one rip, you know, that's kind of what was going through my head. And yeah, and then once you feel it once, you can kind of continue feeling the same. So yeah, I guess was kind of the process.
What are you thinking going into the NCAA meet, and what are your expectations, and how do you approach it mentally?
So I guess my approach to this upcoming meet would be, it's more of a learning experience, to be honest. Like, this is a huge meet. I've never seen anything like this. So I guess it's like a low pressure kind of like, do what I can, you know, I don't have to PR. It's just like exposure for the most part. Maybe talk to some of the older girls who have been there before. And thankfully my teammate Tyler is actually going to be there with me. So I guess just kind of feel the energy, be excited to be there, and hope to go for the next 3 years too.
Yeah. Let's talk about Tyler Delgado for a second as well, because he comes in second at the NE10 championship. He's going to the NCAA championship. He's in his last year at Assumption. He had not thrown javelin since he was in high school until this year. So what's in the water in Worcester that you guys are just coming on strong on that unit?
I'm not sure. I mean, we have an incredible coach, so I just want to shout her out for just getting people involved who may not understand like track as much, or like what they can do with it. So there's that. And I don't know, Tyler's just an awesome kid, you know. He just walked on. He's very nonchalant about his track career, but still he's making noise. So I think that's great. And I hope for the best for both of us, I guess, at the national tournament.
When did you first touch a javelin? Like, when was this a thing that you thought to try?
Well, I used to do the heptathlon in high school. So I guess, like, just for the heptathlon, I would try javelin. It was never one of my events until, like, my senior year. And then I started actually competing, like, the whole season for it. So, yeah, I guess my senior year of high school.
Was javelin always one of your favorites or at the forefront? I know you were a really good long jumper. I know you set a school record. When did javelin become like the one that stood out?
Well, I guess I wouldn't say it's still my favorite event. I do really like long jump, and I like to the running events can be a lot of fun. But I guess like I just started winning more in javelin. It was just a stronger event for me, and so I really started following that, I guess, is the turning point.
How do you go from like just going to school to like now we're throwing javelin at the NCAA championships and it's like, all right, now I'm seeing what else I can explore. I like the running events. I like the long jump events to potentially building into somebody that can maybe score across multiple disciplines for your team.
Yeah, I mean, well, I did like club volleyball and club basketball my first semester. So I was still practicing every day. Like I didn't want to just do school and not be involved in athletics because I'm so passionate for athletics. So yeah, then I was like, I just need to join the team, be something here. And you know, I just kind of like tested the waters first. I do want to like, I've never done an indoor track season either. So next season, I'm actually really excited to test some of those, you know, maybe be a pentathlete, you never know. But yeah, I guess it's all just kind of exposure still, like it's still in the beginning phases, I guess.
Yeah, hard work pays off, I guess, is the mantra there.
Yeah.
What would your August self think if she saw where you were right now?
I don't know. I think I'd probably be like, who is she? You know, like I didn't expect any of this, to be honest. It's all still kind of like not real, you know. But I think I'd be very proud of myself for making the decisions I have and putting the hard work in that I have and still having a positive mindset. You know, obviously not every day is a win. Not every day is perfect. There's bad practices. You still have to persevere and like look for that big goal, you know. And I guess it's just take it one day at a time. And that's probably what I would say to myself now still.
What do your family and friends think?
Oh, well, my friends from back home, they're just like, you're crazy. Like, this is insane. My mom, she's super supportive. It's just all came like so quick, you know, like it's just insane. Like, I don't know. They're super happy for me and they're excited to see where it goes as well.
That's my last question for you. Where does this go? Now that you've accomplished what you've accomplished in such a short amount of time, how does that set the stage for, I know you talk about going into an indoor season and trying to maybe do some multis in the future, but having had the success you've had early, does that change the scope of how you view the next 3 years and what you're capable of and what's possible?
Definitely. Like, I don't know. I've definitely thought about that actually. And it's like, if I set such a high bar at this age, it's like, where, you know, like what's going to happen from there. And I'm trying to think about it in a way that's like, you know what, I'm going to PR again by 20 feet next year and then 10 feet the next year. So it's like, how far can I push it? You never know. Like, I would love to win a national tournament. Like, that would be insane. You know, I'm going to set my goals high and just, you know, just believe in myself and see where it can go. So.
Well, Malina, congratulations on the work so far and certainly best of luck making your mark on the national stage.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.